Hey there, Mustangs, and welcome to school for the week of May 13th.
Let's start off the week with the Pledge of Allegiance. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? Begin.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America
and to the Republic for which it stands.
One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Job well done. Let's see what's happening at Westlake this week.
Hey there, Mustangs. We have arrived at the finish line of the school-wide RISE testing. That was 4 weeks, writing, language arts, math, and science. Yes, we do have some makeups, and we are still getting some of those who need some more time on the science. But as a whole, we have finished the school-wide testing initiative, and it's been quite the process. I've shared this graph with you in the past, and I want to share it with you right now. English language arts, unfortunately, we don't have any data for. We got a big question mark there because we have found out that data will not come back until the fall. However, we believe that you did very well. All the teachers who watched you, your proctor teachers, were so impressed with the way you were writing, the way you were organizing yourselves, and we have a lot of confidence that you are in the ballpark for having beaten and set a new school best in that category. Math, even with all the finishing up we did this week, we still have 24% of our students proficient. That is a jump of 4%, a new personal school best. Never in the history have the Westlake students done that well. In science, unfortunately, we still have some 250 kids who haven't finished. So right now, I can't say concretely that we've got the right answer. We had a school best last year that jumped up 4% from 22 to 26%. This year, right now, we're just slightly under 25%. So it's not quite there yet, but like I said, there's still 250 kids who have to finish. It puts us in a little bit of an awkward situation because we have a STEM Rising Festival we were scheduled for this Friday, and we need to make a decision of whether we qualified or not. Based on the fact that we were looking for two of the three subjects to get a new school best, we know we got math. We think we got language arts, and we don't know yet that we haven't gotten science. I've consulted with the teachers, and we feel that, yes, you have earned your STEM Rising Festival, and we will do that this Friday. In addition to that, this is kind of exciting. I have more than 50% of the school who have already earned a personal best on at least one of the two subjects. We'll be getting their free t-shirt and also their taco coming up here shortly. So we're excited for you. Congratulations. That'll be this Friday. We'll have more information coming. Thank you, Mustangs.
Yay, congratulations, Mustangs, and job well done. We have 9 days of school left. Let's hear a little bit more of what we can expect.
Students, the last 9 days of the year are by far some of the funnest. We are excited about celebrating your accomplishments from RISE testing at the STEM RISE Festival this Friday. Having said that, we want to maintain our normal expectations this week, including getting to class on time. Therefore, we are also excited to announce that you have a clean slate with tardies. What that means is that in order to come to the STEM Rising Festival, you must have less than 4 tardies this week. If you have more than that, you will start to lose some of your STEM Rising Festival. Additionally, we expect your behavior this week to be such that you are not seen sent to time away more than twice during the week. Again, if you are, you will lose the opportunity to fully participate in the STEM Rising Festival. Next week has several other fun activities as well, and we'll discuss on the next week's Mustang Media what will be needed to be eligible to participate. In many ways, this is the best part of the whole year. We want you to finish strong and to make sure you get to participate in everything you want to.
Thanks. Be on your best game, Mustangs.
Oh, hey, have you heard about the money wars going on at our school? It's lunchtime. Follow me and I'll explain it to you. So basically, Money Wars is a fundraising competition between the 7th graders and 8th graders to see who can raise the most money. 8th graders, do you remember last year when we got to go to the Classic Fun Center and we raised the most money? Let's try to do that again this year. Come on, 8th graders, donate as much money as you can so that we can go to Classic Fun Center again.
Actually, that's a lie. You know who's going to win this year? The 7th grade. Okay?
You probably just heard from a 7th grader that they're gonna win. Well, let me tell you this. 8th graders know what it's like. We won it last year. So 8th graders, please donate as much money as you can. Let's win it this year again. One more reminder. This fundraiser will start on May 13th. Start saving up. This fundraiser is only a week long. Come on, 8th graders. Come on, 7th graders.
Last week was Teacher Appreciation Week. Let's see a recap.
Yo, Miss Bigelow.
To you, Miss Rowling.
Hey, Mr. Dude.
Miss Slater.
Hey, Mr. Merman.
Thank you, Mr. Chief.
Hi, Miss Cuomo.
Oh, hey, Mr. Todd.
Hi, Miss Reno.
Hey, Mr. Edwards.
Hi, Miss Longstaff.
Hey, Miss Cole.
Mr. Maddox.
Hi, Miss Barker.
Hi, Mr. Howe.
Hey, Miss Hess.
Hey, Miss Handy.
Thanks, Miss Reeser.
Thank you, Mr. Moore.
Hey, Miss Kimwood.
Hi, Mrs. Sanchez.
Hey, Miss Lowe.
Hey, Mr. Rowan.
Hi, Miss Evans.
Hey, Miss Coons.
Hey, Mr. Nichols.
Hi, Miss Bodell.
Thank you, Mr. Booth.
Hi, Miss Ramos.
Hola, Senor Ferrerons.
Hey, Miss Walt.
Miss Bishop.
Hey, Mr. Schaefer.
I want to appreciate Mr. Dunn.
Hey, Miss Brundage.
Hey, Miss Pack.
Hey, Miss Bridge.
Happy Teacher Appreciation Week, Mrs. Jones.
To Miss Williams.
Hi, Miss Stansberry.
Hey, Mr. Marcin.
Miss Waltier.
Hi, Miss Watts.
Hey, Madam Carroll.
Hey, Miss Hubert.
Hi, Miss Shay.
Hey, Mr. Hover.
Hey, Mr. C.
Hello, Miss Horton. You're currently watching from TV.
Hey, Miss Bowman.
Hi, Miss Eaton. I really enjoyed your class. You're really nice. You're really sweet.
I just want to say thank you for being a great teacher. And
I feel like that's like really, that was a really hard concept for me, but it really helped me out.
And actually understanding it this year.
For having the patience to teach my class.
Making class fun and easy and just being a teacher.
Thank you for teaching me to not give up and to always do my best.
Thank you for being a funny teacher.
I miss that class a lot. You knew how to teach.
What do you believe in me when I don't believe in myself?
I love being in there. You're an awesome teacher.
So glad you were one of my teachers.
Thank you for being so nice and chill throughout the year.
I can have something to look forward to when I come to school.
You really impacted my life.
You teach math really well.
I really appreciate how you do so much for the school.
You are always there when I need help. And
I just wanted to thank you for always being concerned about what's happening in my life and what's happening in school for me.
I just wanted to say thank you for all that you do for me and my class.
Thank you for all the fun activities that you had for our class and all the laughters.
He makes a lot of great jokes, pretty corny, you know.
For being a kind and friendly teacher, you push me to do my best.
Thank you for everything you do for the school and you do for me.
Thank you for everything you do for us.
Thank you for always asking me how my day is.
You helped me start running again and get back into physical fitness.
Thank you for caring about me. You're really great.
You help explain things when I don't understand it.
Thank you so much for taking the time to help us understand.
I just wanted to thank you for always making sure I'm comfortable in school.
For always being there for me and being there for me for hard times.
You always care about everyone and you're really nice.
Es un muy buen maestro y que me ha enseñado muchas cosas.
I know you have been supportive with me in everything that I would have told you. You are a big help in my life.
For also helping me with stuff that I have in English.
Thank you for being such a good math teacher and helping with me with my grades.
And thank you for being the best science teacher.
We love you and thank you.
Helping me for all my problems. Thank you.
You're such a great English teacher and like to support all of our fellow peers.
Thank you for helping me with everything.
Thank you for helping me with my schoolwork.
Thank you for being such a great teacher and teaching us science.
We love you so much.
I hope you have a great day.
Whenever I went to your class, I always had an amazing time.
keep doing what you're doing because you're great.
You're so amazing because not only did you teach me about history, but you also taught me a lot of life skills.
Thanks for always teaching us in class and making class fun.
I am really glad that I got you as a history teacher because you're actually really beefy with your details.
Thank you for the typing class. I really appreciate it.
We love you.
I wouldn't be me today without you. Thank you.
Thank you, teachers. We're so grateful for all that you do for us. Last week, our Mustang shined in a production of Addams Family Musical. Let's take a look.
With a simple click, scandalously quick,
I can face a new tomorrow if I make it past today.
I feel good saying death is just around the corner, so it play on its way.
Congrats to the students for an amazing show. Let's recognize a few more STEM Crazy Students of the Week.
They can call me whatever they want, call me crazy. You can call me whatever you want, but that won't change me. I just don't care.
My nomination for Zero Quitting is Mackenzie Torres. She's super hardworking, she's dedicated. She even emailed me multiple times, came in after school to fix her science notebook. Way to go, Mackenzie. Keep up the good work.
For Zero Quitting, Abigail Garcia, she always does her work. She works her hardest. She always makes sure that she gets her work in on time, even if she's not going to be in class. She's a great example of zero quitting. Great job, Abigail.
Hey, Westlake. I nominate Alejandro Ruiz for Zero Quitting. He works really hard in my English 8 class. Whether he's feeling good or not, he always redoes his papers and checks with me and sends his work in on time. He's awesome.
They can call me whatever they want, call me crazy. You can call me whatever you want, but that won't change me. I just don't care what the world says, I'm gonna make it.
That's it for us. Thanks for watching.
This is Mustang Media. Success will find you no matter where you go and what you do. As you leave us today, just know that my heart will always find you in it. Goodbye.
Nothing lasts forever. Forever is a lie. All we have is what's in between. Hello and goodbye.
We'll take the best, forget the rest, and someday find that these are the best of times. There are goodbyes for us. Wherever you are, you will always be in my heart.
Today we close the door to the past, open the door to the future. Take a deep breath and step on through and start a new chapter in our lives. Once a Mustang, always a Mustang.